The following chapter deals with the special features of the fuel system on the DE variant of the M272 engine. Let's concentrate first on the low pressure side of the fuel circuit. How does it differ from the circuit on the port injection variant? On the direct injection engine, the fuel pressure on the low pressure side is not controlled by a pressure regulating valve, but is instead recorded by a special sensor. Specifically, the fuel pressure sensor located in the feed line downstream of the filter. The signal from the fuel pressure sensor is recorded by the fuel pump control unit. The pressure readings are sent via the sensor data bus to the ME control unit. The ME control unit checks the current fuel pressure against a map and forwards the recalculated pressure specifications to the fuel pump control unit. The fuel pump control unit regulates the rotational speed and thereby the pump delivery rate via a PWM signal until the required fuel pressure is achieved. Low fuel pressure is regulated between approximately 3.0 and 5.5 bar, depending on engine operating status and fuel temperature. The fuel supplied by the low pressure pump and the return line from the high pressure side converge at the low pressure fuel supply rail. The fuel is forwarded from the low pressure fuel supply rail to the high pressure pump. Fuel temperature at the inlet to the high pressure pump may not exceed around 70 degrees centigrade. The temperature is monitored by the ME control unit with the aid of the fuel temperature sensor. This is incorporated into the low pressure fuel supply rail. A fuel cooler is incorporated into the return line to lower the fuel temperature. Spray-guided direct injection requires a high fuel pressure of up to 200 bar. The high-pressure pump delivers fuel at the appropriate pressure to both rails via the high-pressure fuel supply rail. By the way, the stainless steel high-pressure lines must not be reused once they have been removed because the tightness of the joints can no longer be guaranteed. The pressure is stored in the rails. The rail pressure sensor continually informs the ME control unit about the current pressure in the rails. The control unit regulates the rail pressure by means of two actuators, namely the quantity control valve, which is incorporated into the high pressure pump, and the pressure regulating valve. This is mounted on the high pressure fuel supply rail. Both valves are controlled with PWM signals. The quantity control valve is closed when a continuous current is applied, in other words, when the pulse duty factor is 100%. With the pressure regulating valve, it's exactly the opposite. It closes if no current is applied, in other words, when the pulse duty factor is zero. Which of the two valves plays the main role in regulating the high fuel pressure depends on the engine's operating status. The high-pressure starting operating status prevails up to approximately 5 seconds after engine start. In high-pressure starting conditions, the quantity control valve is closed by applying a continuous current. The high-pressure pump can therefore supply fuel at the full delivery rate, which enables pressure to be built up quickly. In high-pressure starting conditions, the rail pressure is regulated exclusively by the pressure regulating valve. During a high-pressure start, the low fuel pressure is regulated to between 5 and 5.5 bar. Normal operation refers to fault-free driving mode and applies to all load ranges. In normal operating mode, the pressure regulating valve is de-energized and therefore closed. In normal operating mode, rail pressure is regulated exclusively by means of the quantity control valve. The low fuel pressure is regulated to between 3 and 5.5 bar in normal mode. The control parameter for low pressure is the fuel temperature. The aim is to prevent bubble formation. In the switching off operating state, the pressure regulating valve and the quantity control valve are operated for a further 60 seconds, or so to release the pressure via the return line. During this period, no current is applied to the quantity control valve. In other words, the valve is open. By contrast, the pressure regulating valve is actuated with a pulse duty factor of approximately 70%. In other words, it is held approximately 70% open. The low pressure fuel pump is not actuated during the switch-off procedure. If certain problems occur with the high pressure circuit, the system is switched to the low pressure emergency operating mode. The quantity control valve is open in this operating state. Because this means that the maximum amount of fuel is diverted, it is no longer possible to generate a high pressure. The pressure regulating valve is held open with a pulse duty factor of approximately 70%. This means that the rails are only supplied with fuel from the low pressure fuel pump, in other words, at a pressure of 5 to 5.5 bar. The low rail pressure is compensated for by actuating the injectors for a longer period. The stratified charge mode is not permitted during low pressure emergency operation. Engine power is reduced to the extent that it's only possible to achieve a top speed of 70 km per hour. A special fuel injector has been developed to handle the extremely short injection intervals of stratified charge mode on the DE engine. It utilizes the piezoelectric principle. Let's have a look at this in detail. The nozzle module opens outwards. Thanks to its geometry, it is able to form a hollow conical spray which, in the spray-guided combustion process, must have a precisely defined shape and must maintain that shape for all operating conditions. Lengthwise, the actuator module is structured as a series of layers. This way, the expansion lengths of the individual piezo layers are added together for a cumulative effect. A coupler module is used to hold both the actuator module and the nozzle module free of play in the direction of expansion. This ensures that the entire longitudinal expansion of the piezo layers can act on the nozzle needle free of play. The fuel feed line supplies the injector with fuel at high pressures of up to 200 bar. The injector is actuated by the ME control unit via the electrical connections. The operating voltage is between 125 and 160 volts. The control current, approximately 8 amperes.